Welcome to First Glance with Jody Vance, and I can honestly tell you that today's subject matter hits very close to home for me as an individual, and I'm certain will for you, our viewer. Obviously, at First Glance, if this is your first time tuning in, our goal is to ensure that we shine light on opportunities for investors, not just those in expensive suits and pocket squares, but also those who maybe are looking for the perfect fit, something that makes their heart feel better, makes them feel like they're invested in a soulful way as well as in a financial way. So very pleased to introduce the CEO of Perimeter Medical Imaging. Jeremy Sobotta is with us. I'm so excited to talk through your company's mission here, Jeremy. Thanks for doing this.
Hi, Jody. Thanks for having us. We're excited to talk about it ourselves.
So beginning with the most amazing stock symbol ever in PINK, P-I-N-K, hello, PINK. The story behind what Perimeter Medical Imaging is all about is really mind-bogglingly futuristic almost in what's before us. So in layman's terms, can you give us the story of your company?
Yeah, definitely. So our symbol PINK, we're traded on the TSXV. So PINK for us is an allusion to the Breast Cancer Awareness Month, the pink ribbons that raise awareness for breast cancer. And the problem we're going after solving is in a breast cancer surgery today, particularly a lumpectomy, surgeons do not have the tools available to them to assess the patient in real time and know that they've removed all of the cancer after that operation. So what ends up happening is they do their best, and it's a complicated procedure. It's you're in a very difficult place to access within the patient. It's dark. They have to use different techniques to try to ensure they get it all out. But unfortunately, about 25% of the time, they leave some behind. And what happens is that that patient's specimen is sent to a pathology lab. That pathology lab takes a week to evaluate to make sure the surgeon removed it all. And 25% of the time, or a little over 50,000 women in North America annually, have to go back for another operation for the surgeon to remove more tissue. And what our technology does is it gives the surgeon that information in real time in the operating room, so they don't have to wait that week, and they can assess those. It's called a margin assessment. They can assess those margins right in the operation and avoid the $50,000 and $500 million cost of all those reoperations annually in North America.
I'm going to press pause on the cost and the impacts from a medical perspective. As somebody who has literally sat with a family member who has waited for results and then being told that she had to go back for second surgery, the fear and the angst associated with that wait, when you said that would be happening in real time, it's visceral, the feeling. And for those who go through a lumpectomy and go through that wait and then get the good news that those margins are fine, had they been able to hear that upon coming out of their anesthesia, like the difference in the life impacts, the trauma for people, women, and some men, because I've also lost a friend to breast cancer who is a man, these are monumental. They can't be overstated, the level of relief that comes with this intelligence that you're bringing to the table here. And this is just for breast cancer at this point, right? It could be expanded to other levels, right?
Exactly right. Yeah, you're spot on. And there's really two viewpoints from that perspective. So I'll move on to the patient after telling
Tell
you about
me.
What.
Yeah.
The, yeah. So
sure.
What the surgeons also feel, obviously, there isn't a surgeon out there that's satisfied with 75% success on the first run.
No.
And what our key opinion leaders will tell us is the number one worst call they have to make is to call a patient and tell them they have cancer. A very close second is to tell them they tried to remove it and didn't get it all, and now they have to come back for a second operation.
Yeah.
And as I mentioned, they don't have the tools today to help them with that. So what our technology does is gives those surgeons control back and gives them peace of mind. And so they can do the best job possible and ensure that they can avoid those difficult calls for a second operation as often as possible.
Amazing.
And that same piece, yeah, that same peace of mind transitions to the patient. And, you know, you're exactly what you described is exactly right. And actually, Suzanne Foster, who sits on our board of directors, is a breast cancer survivor. She, you know, she articulates this really well as, you know, she worked in the industry, knew surgery very well. And when you get the call that you need an operation, there's always that little nagging thing in the back of your mind, like, did the surgeon get it all? And even if they tell you that they did, you're still really not sure because of the gap in notification and in getting the results. So exactly what you described, getting it in real time and having that additional peace of mind and sense of security that the surgeon did it right and they had control and were able to make the decision to get it all the first time is a big win across really all the constituents.
Indeed. This is that breakthrough moment in science and medicine that it will radically change the experience that no one wishes on even their worst enemy. Again, the stock symbol is PINK. The company's name is Perimeter Medical Imaging. So you're looking at PINK. It's so easy to remember, P-I-N-K. Jeremy Sobotta is the CEO. And Jeremy, where are we at with regard to FDA clearance and real-time use of this incredible technology?
Yeah, we're at probably the most exciting point in Perimeter's history. So the technology has been developed since 2013, and classic medical device company takes a long time from R&D and doing clinical studies. And we're very excited. We just announced an updated 510K clearance on our technology. So this brings in all of the game-changing enhancements that we've been hearing from our surgeons over the last several years and makes it ready for commercialization. So on the backside of that, we are ready to do a limited launch later this month with a full wide-scale launch, ready to get it out in the hands of surgeons and impacting patients' lives in the next couple of months.
Wow, a long journey from 2003, did you say?
2013.
Okay, I was like, holy cow. Okay, so still that's 8 years. That's a dedicated, you must be incredibly excited about where you are standing right now.
I can't put it into words how excited we are. And this is the culmination of, you know, significant work from both, you know, folks inside the company, really smart engineers working with really cool technology, but also a litany of key opinion leaders and surgeons that have given us, you know, direct feedback from the user's perspective. So really, really exciting.
This is just, I mean, to reiterate the human impacts of this, having had on so many levels, so the experience and certainly being a woman, I think this is resonating in my mind because every woman, every time we go for a mammogram, we fear that lump. And then having to have perhaps the ultrasound and then the lumpectomy and then that weight, of all of that, the most terrifying thing would be that weight.
Yeah, 100%. Exactly right. And, you know, that's getting harder and harder. So our technology is becoming even more and more relevant because people are detecting cancer earlier. They're, you know, the lumpectomies are smaller and you know, different cancer types. So having this technology now is better than at any point in the history of being, you know, being available to surgeons. So,
all right, grab your pencils, write it down. Perimeter Medical Imaging. The stock symbol is PINK. I'm speaking with Jeremy Sobotta about this. And in terms of once we are, I mean, as you said right off the top, there's a reason why it's PINK. The pink ribbon, breast cancer awareness, how this will impact breast cancer specifically. How might your company grow then into applying this to other types of cancer? Is there sort of a roadmap to where you go next?
Yeah, exactly. So the clearance we have and the underlying imaging technology could apply to really any solid state cancer. So margin assessment is very important in things like pancreas cancer or kidney cancer. So surgeons could already use that technology for that. But what is tissue specific for us is our artificial intelligence, which we haven't really talked about yet. And this is, you know, really image interpretation is the perfect use case for AI. And we're continuing to collect additional data to train AI for breast cancer. And then our roadmap beyond that would be to make new AI tissue specific algorithms for things like lung, head and neck, you know, prostate, et cetera. So really a platform technology, and we want it to be used in really every single cancer surgery out there would be our goal.
It can expand to unlimited. So can you, I don't like to say dumb it down for me, but can you kind of just unpack, I guess, the AI piece? Like when you talk about in real time, because in my mind, old school, I can think of a test, you know, the surgeon takes out everything that he or she can see looks like cancer or is on the image that appears like cancer, but it's that unseen cell that might exist just next to where they remove the cancer from. So how will AI come together with that?
Yeah, so what happens is when the surgeon's looking at the specimen they've removed, you can appreciate that there's, you know, with the level of resolution we're providing, there's a fair amount of volume of images to scan through. So what the AI does, similar to like a radiologist in a mammography who's looking for different features within the image, what the AI does is highlights those features within the image so the surgeon can quickly scan on the parts that are relevant to them and know, okay, I can ignore some of that other stuff because the AI has highlighted the regions of suspicion for me. So it really, with the patient under anesthesia, OR time is expensive, the AI, you know, expedites the review and gives them even more confidence that they're looking at the right information in the images.
Right. So what used to be a group of physicians or experts or radiologists that were sifting through the pictures, the AI now does that like that fast.
Exactly right. Yeah.
Amazing. Oh my God, Jeremy, this is so exciting. Seriously. Reiterating again, as I'm dumbfounded by what I'm learning here. I love my job. Perimeter medical imaging stock symbol is PINK for investors wanting to be a part of something that really is standing at the precipice. Obviously there's risk with all investment, but I mean, from 2013 until hello, 2021, I can see the goosebumps on my arm. This is that moment. We're really standing at that breakthrough moment that in medicine, and not just in this area of medicine, but we've been hearing for years how things are going to evolve and change like that when it comes to AI and genetics. Here we are.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And you know, this, the cancer surgery workflow, there's still a lot of room for innovation in the operating room. So if you think about what has happened over the last several years, you hear a lot about early detection and you hear a lot about, you know, drug therapy post-op, but meanwhile, the actual operation isn't that different. So we're bringing game-changing technology into the OR right where it's needed at a time that it's needed most. So could not be more thrilled. And like you said, 2021 for us is really that breakout year, commercializing the technology we've been developing, lots of clinical milestones in the next several months on the AI development. So really now is the time to be watching and to be getting involved with Perimeter for sure.
Okay, well, if there are clinical milestones coming up, will you promise me to come back and share them here on First Glance with Jody Vance? I personally want to hear how this story continues to unfold.
It'd be my pleasure to come back and give you those updates, Jody.
Fabulous. Okay, how do people find out more about you? Is there a website that everybody can go to or maybe be able to reach out with investor questions?
Yeah, definitely. We're on all the social media platforms. So you can find us on, you know, Twitter and et cetera. And our website is perimetermed.com.
Perimetermed.com. One word.
One word. Yep.
This is me writing it down. I'm so excited. Honestly, this is just fantastic. Thank you for taking the time out today. And I look forward to our next discussion where you give me another good news update on something that we've all been touched by in one form or another and really appreciate all your hard work.
Great stuff. Thanks for having us.